Welcome to all. I am Alistair. This video give you demonstration on process creation, exercise number 3B. Okay. How we create a process and how we execute some task inside the process. The function for creating the process is fork, F-O-R-K. The function getPID is to get the process ID of the current process. GetPPID is to get the process of its process ID of the parent process. For example, inside the child, if you want to get the process ID of its own, then use the function getPID. Suppose inside the child, if you want to get the process ID of its parent, use the function getPPID. Okay, now come to the question number one. Find the output of the following. Output of the following. The first exercise, I have already typed the program. This is exercise number one. Exercise number 1.c. Okay, see. Here the value of A and B are 5 and 10 respectively. So here I am printing something before the process is created. Before fork, the value of A and B is 5 and 10. After fork, the entire statement will be executed both in parent and child. Okay. After the fork, the entire thing will be executed by both parent and child. So both parent and child will execute in a different address space. So no communication between the child and parent. In child, the process fork, the function fork returns 0. So the condition will be true in child. So the then part will be executed in child, else part will execute in parent. Okay, there is no communication. So here we have modified the value of A by increasing 1. This change of value A and B will not reflect in parent. Okay, initially value of A and B is 10. So suppose the process child execute first, value of A and B will become 6 and 11. But when it comes to parent, the value of A and B will be 5 and 10 only, because the value modified by the child will not reflect in parent. Okay. Now I'll execute. I'll save the program. Save. Come to the prompt. Compile this program. GCC x1.c. Compiled it. No error, /a.out, run the program. See, value of A is 5 and 10 initially before fork, before the process creation. In child, the process value A and B has been increased by 1. In parent, the value of A and B has been decreased by 1. This parent has took the value before the process creation, not the value modified by child. Okay, and then second question. Second question, rewrite the program using VFork, virtual fork. Okay, so you see this program, the second program, just I have modified the fork by VFork. VFork is virtual fork. It means the both child and parent will use the same address space. So if value modified by A and B will reflect in B, but here the value of A and B, same value of A and B has been used in parent, so you will get an error. Segmentation fault. So I will show you the output for VFork. Come to the prompt. Okay, here I compile the program. ex2.c /a.out. Value of A and B is B and 11, but in parent the value of A is something else and B is something else, and we are getting segmentation fault because the address space of child is used by parent. So there is a problem of accessing the value of A and B. So we get segmentation fault, virtual fork. VFork means virtual fork. Okay. Same address space. Question number three, calculate the number of times SRM IST is printed. There are three forks. Okay. How we get, how many times the process will be created? I will show you one diagram for this. See this, There are three forks. This diagram is only for two fork. The first L1 represents the parent process. The first fork creates two process, L2, L3. Okay. The second fork creates two process under L2. L3, 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 L3. So this first two L3 is for the first process. Second two L3 for the second process. So after the second fork, we will have four process. After the third fork, we will have four more, eight, we will have four, sorry, two process in each and every L3. Okay, L3 will have, this L3 will have two process, and this L3 two process, this L3 two, and this L3. Totally we have eight process. Okay, understood? Fork will create two process, and second fork will create two process under the existing two process. So totally four process. Third fork create two process under the existing four process. So we'll get totally eight process. So if you execute the program, I think program number, is it program number 3? Yeah, program number 3, SRM. I'll execute this program. GCC EX 3.C dot class A dot out. You see, there are 8 SRM get printed. Okay, what is the, why it is printing the prompt here in between and then SRM, some SRM later? The reason is there are 8 process. Among 8, only one process is parent. The first process is parent. If the parent terminates, then the control will come back to the calling place, that is prompt. Okay, here in this case, out of 8, after 3 process has been executed, the parent process terminated, then remaining 5 process executed. That's the reason we get the prompt intermediately and then followed by some 5 SRMs. So the choice of selecting the process is based on the operating system. So we cannot expect the order, but the output will be same. How many SRMs? There are 8 SRMs, 8 process. There is no change in the number of processes, but the order of the process changed. And one more thing, since the parent executed, terminated earlier, the child doesn't know how to terminate. So it is blinking here. If you press enter, you will get the prompt. Even if you run the same program for the second time, you will get different order. For example, you see I compiled again and I'm run. You see, two process executed before the parent and then all other 6 process executed later. Okay, so you are, I hope you understand the concept of the way of executing. The order will be different. There are 8 process. 8 process may executed in any order. Okay, come to question number 4. The question number 4 is calculate the program. Means in this question number 4, I asked you to find out the sum of odd number in child process, sum of even number in parent process. Okay, that is question number 4. Okay, see, the question number 4 has been written in exercise 7.C. Okay, this is the program. Here you see, print of enter the value of n, we get the value of n using scanf, and then here we are creating the process, and then this then part is child, else part is parent. In then part, you see, for I equal to 1 to I less than or equal to n, I equal to I plus 2, I am finding the sum of odd number. Okay, and print the sum of odd number inside the parent, in the child. Here sum of even number you are finding. I start I with from 0. Here I start I with I from 1. Okay, this program will give you the sum of odd number and sum of even number. I'll explain. I'll execute the program. Compile the program, GCC EX7.C. Okay, dot slash A dot out. This program will ask you value for n. N is 10. I have given. See, here the sum of odd number is 25. Sum of even number is 30. Okay, so from this we could clearly understand And come to question number 5. This question number 5 is very similar to question number 3. Here there are three fork creates 8 process. It means 2 power 3. Similarly, here there are n process. N times a fork is called. If n time is called, 0 to n minus 1 means n time is called. How many process will be there? 2 power n. Or how many child process are 2 power n minus 1, except the parent, the child is 2 power n minus 1. So totally 2 power n process will be there, will be created. Come to question number 6. Here in question number 6, I am asking you to print the child process ID and parent process ID in both child and parent. Okay, I'll show you. There is a program for this one. I think the program is program 4. Yeah, program 4. Here you see, I'll explain the logic. Here we create a process, and the then part is child process, executed in child process, and else part executed in parent process. In child process, if you want child ID, get PID we use. In child, we get the parent process, get PPID. In parent, the fork returns a child process ID in parent. So it is enough to print the value of PID for child process. You see, I am printing only PID. And the parent ID, if you want, get PID. Okay. Now I'll explain how I'll execute this one at exx4.c. Okay, here a dot out. See, both child ID and parent ID in both child and parent is same. Okay. Now you come to the next question, that is last question. How many child processes are created for the following code? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 forks, but the 5 forks are not given in an order. So I'll show you a diagram for this one. You see, you'll understand how many number of forks. Take the first fork as A, second fork as B, third fork as C, fourth fork as D, and last fork as E. The fork A and E will be executed without any condition, but B and C are grouped. If the value of fork B and C is true, then fork D will not be executed. If B and D is false, then fork D will be executed. Okay, you see this. This fork A create two process. Fork A create two process. Fork B creates two process. Fork B create two process. Fork C create two process. Suppose the fork B, assume that this is true and this is false. What do you mean by true? Fork returns 0 and non-zero. Two value. Fork returns two value. 0 in child, non-zero in parent. If you are non-zero in parent is called as true. Okay. Suppose if it is true, okay, fork B is true and C is true. In which case B is true and C is true, this is B is true, then D will be executed. Okay. So this fork A creates two process, fork B creates two process, and fork C creates. Suppose if B is true, if B is false, this is B, if B is false, definitely it will not execute C. Here itself the condition false, so it will go to the fork D. Suppose if C, fork B is true, then fork C will be created, and fork C creates another process. If both are false, if B is false and if C is false, both B and C are false, then fork D create two process. Here this is the case where B is false and C is false. If B is false, then two process will be created. D create two process. But for B is true, D is created. So based on the condition, the process creates. Totally we will get 20 process created in this case. Okay. 20 process will be created in this case. I hope you understand the concepts of process creation. I stop with this. Let's see in the next video. Thank you for watching.